They don't want the objection to sell out the deal like a bland piece of bread. Do you notice that everything's fun until somebody says an objection? And then people are like, you know what I mean? What do they do when the objection comes in? Him, we're on a test drive. Mm-hmm. You get off the test drive. Ian's like, hey, if I can get the deal right, would you be happy to take it home? And I say, look, Ian, I appreciate it, man, but look, I never buy on my first stop.
Andy, look, man, I completely understand. Not typically do I buy anything on my first stop also. But what you've told me today is it's actually not your first stop. You've been online for, I mean, you've went to 30 different websites before you found our vehicle. So it's technically not really your first stop. What I'd like to do is I'd like to go inside and just give you a 5-minute proposal. That way, when you go home tonight, you truly have something to think about. So would that be cool with you?
Cool. Done? Let's go. Grab the brother. Guys, think about what he said. Let's grab him. Did you see how he said, it's really not your first stop? And then he said, I bet you've been online, you looked on websites. That was good. Did you guys pick up something there? So when you hear that, you're thinking, you know what?
Change that reality.
Maybe logically, in the pavement, this is the first place, but they've been somewhere, okay? So it's not. Call them out on it. All right, cool. So Evan, me and him going to test drive, we get back, okay? He asked me to buy the car, and I'm like, hey, Evan, I appreciate it, but I don't ever buy my first stop.
Andy, it's been so good getting to know you. Number one, man, I just love the fact that we've spent so much time together getting to know you. It's been freaking amazing. Look, Andy, would you agree over the last 2 years, 2020, 21, times have been crazy, right?
Yeah.
Things have changed, man. You probably order these tight shirts like from your house. You know, you probably, you know, you go to the gym, you get yelled at by the front desk lady because you don't have your mask on or it's hanging down below your nose or something. Or wherever you shop for your short shorts, you got to come in with a mask. Right?
Right.
Right, Andy? Look, times have changed.
Like, right.
2020 changed. 2021, things are changing. It's the era of transparency and speed, Andy. Look, listen, when you came in looking for a vehicle, this vehicle hit on all the critical tasks or all the critical things that you wanted to buy a car, right? You say you never buy on your first stop, but did you feel comfortable with purchasing a vehicle with me today? Right, Andy? You told me you did, right? So what, I'm here, you're here, the car's here. Let's make business today and let's not have to, you go to lot looking for vehicles. Let's make the deal work today for you, Andy.
Okay, watch this, hold on. That right there, that was great. Now watch. You hear what he said and you hear what he said, right? You guys right now, while they're talking, you should be writing stuff down and you guys could build out a power one. Am I right? Okay. Look, I mean, Sean gets quotes, right? People call Sean to get quotes for shipping. Guy calls, he's like, hey man, I'm gonna get a couple more quotes. It's the same thing, I never buy my first stop, I'm gonna get a couple more quotes. See what I'm saying? It's the same thing, we all deal with the same stuff, okay? Now think about it, right? Ian, Evan, you guys heard the difference between,
hey, mine was
right?
Just the sharpshooter.
Think about what Ian said.
You know?
Think about what Evan said. All right, guys, we're gonna vote, okay? Now the objection was easy. I never buy my first stop, right?
It's not really an objection.
I never buy my first stop. What did Ian say? Ian said, I bet it's not
change
the first
the reality.
Stop. I bet that you've been online,
you've
done a little homework, right? Remember, what did Ian say?
Mm-hmm.
I bet you've been online. I bet you did a little homework,
right? You told
me, right?
You've been online.
So guess what?
And they're,
hey,
always going to say that.
Even he said, you told me you've been online. But listen, the fact is that people probably have been online, right? You could go back and you say, hey, wouldn't you agree that times have changed, people have changed, things have changed? You see, a long time ago, whenever I used to hear this is my first stop, truly, people had to drive into the lot, so the only way for them to get different options or even to see other vehicles was to go lot to lot. So that's why I need to, you know, I'm not buying on my first stop was actually a real valid deal. But now, there's not your first stop. This is probably your 30th stop. You've been doing the web browsing just like everybody does. Most of these decisions have already been pre-made before you guys got here. So now that you're here, you checked the car out. You told me you love the way it drives. You told me it had the safety for your family. It's got the low miles and the warranty that you wanted, and it's going to fit well within your budget. So it's not a matter of if you're going to buy, it's when. And the when is when the deal's right, right?
Mm-hmm.
Cool. So if I could save you some time and money, would that upset you in any way? Would you be upset with me at all? Thank goodness. Follow me inside. Boom. Do you guys feel me?
Mm-hmm.
Both of these people, Ian and Evan, said some things that we don't cover in the word tracks. They're new. Guys, we've got 100 different ways to cover this scenario. The question is, do you have one way when you leave here that's tattooed on your heart? Okay, right? If I pulled you up here, did you notice right whenever I said I want to buy anything on my first stop, they both start going to cracking jokes and having fun? Why? They don't want the objection to sell out the deal like a bland piece of bread. Do you notice that everything's fun until somebody says an objection? And then people are like, you know what I mean? What do they do when the objection comes in? Increase the state and have fun. Why would they increase the state and have fun? Because people got to be in a good mood to want to say yes. I want to explain this to you. When somebody gives you an objection, you think automatically that the other person is going to deflate. Would you agree?
Yes.
But what if they increased their state, started laughing and cracking jokes with you, and continued on?
Yeah.
You'd be like, shit, I'm buying something. Am I right?
Yep.
Now you see why it works. Some of you guys, you know what you are? You're one thing short of becoming that new person. You know what it is? Personality. Okay? You guys have got to create these personalities that stand out from everybody else out there, okay? See this. I want you guys to look at this. This is the word track. We teach this, but also you learn the way that these guys are speaking as they're working. Hey, I never bite the first up. I understand, and would you agree that times have changed recently? Okay? By the way, are we gonna make them say yes, or are we asking a question and we're just gonna move on? Hey, let me ask, wouldn't you agree that times have changed recently? Look, however, boom, you just go into it. You don't wait for an answer. Some questions aren't made for an answer. It's a question to get you to think, and then I start talking again. Okay? I understand, wouldn't you agree that times have changed? Do you remember when you could go to a good old American ball game with your family and how you had, but now you have to wear a mask and stand 6 feet apart to just get your groceries for the weeks? Look, the fact is that things have changed since then. And in the past, not buying at your first stop was completely normal. Just like the world has changed, we've changed. We found a better way to do it. Look, you're here, I'm here, the car's here. It's not a matter of if you're gonna buy, but when, and the when is when the deal's right, right? Exactly. So let me show you a 5-quick-minute proposal, and then in the end, it's completely your decision. Does that sound fair? Did you notice you could hear words coming out of their stuff? Guys, one of the things that you can say that really allows people to move to different territory is to say, hey guys, would your times have changed? Things have changed, people have changed. Yeah, you remember in 2019 and then 2020 hit, we had to wear a mask and stand 6 feet apart. That was kind of weird, right? Well, now that that's happened, they found a better way to buy. Look, just like times have changed and people found a better way, there are better ways. Remember how you used to go to Sam's and you have to push that big cart around and load it full of groceries, then go load it up on your car and then go home and, you know, put it in the house, and it took you 4 hours to go shopping? Well, when COVID hit, you got to call, pre-order, and they dropped it off of your front porch. You think anybody's making a Sam's trip anymore? No, because they found a better way to do it. Just like buying a car here today. So just like you used to do things differently before, I totally get it, but there's a better way, and I'm gonna show it to you. The fact that you guys love the vehicle, it's not a matter of if you're gonna buy, it's when. That's when, and the when is gonna be when the deal's right, right? Cool, so if I could show you, save you some time and money, would that offend you in any way? Would that be fair? Yes. Cool, let me get you a 5-minute proposal of all the figures and numbers, and in the end, it's completely your decision. Do you see how we're funneling them down? Mm-hmm. Right? Can they escape it? Mm-mm. No, they can't. And they're with you, and they're there with you to buy. Your goal is, can you make it their idea? Can you make it comfortable for them to say yes? I want to explain something to you. When you make your ask, is it difficult for the customer to say yes? You know that people have certain pride issues to say yes? You know when I tell you I need to think about it? If you run it too quick and then ask me to say yes, I might tell you no due to pride.
Yeah.
Because see, I don't want to get sold. That's why we funnel people down through different stages. I say, hey, wouldn't you agree that times have changed, people have changed, right? Mm-hmm. Notice, I didn't attack the objection. I'm just taking you to unfamiliar territory. And then I made a story about going to Sam's. We used to have to do this, but then we found a better way. Guess what? Now people don't go to Sam's and buy the same old way, just like purchasing a vehicle. Look, guys, if you can remember this word track, it's not a matter of if you're gonna buy, it's when. And when the when is when the deal's right.
Right?
If you can say that, they'll always say, right.
Right.
You could say, cool, so if I could save you some time and money, that wouldn't offend you in any way, would it? Would you be mad at me? Of course you wouldn't. See? You see our body language as we're saying it too? We're teaching this as we're going through it. I want to tell you guys, should any of these be objections for you or problems with you when you go back home?
No.
Okay, but if you don't train, practice. If you don't practice, repetition. What will happen?
You don't.
You won't change. Now, our goal today, as we're training, is for you guys to see a different energy, a different level of excitement. Do you want to have different excitement when you sell?
Crazy.
Cool. If you do, your whole life will change. Everything will change. Do you want to have a different level of excitement? Okay. Some of you guys in here, you're this far away from unlocking. Mm. You're this far, man. You're just like this. You're like a giddy kid. You're like, oh. You know, remember when you were a kid and you wanted a BB gun? You know what I'm saying? You know, and you wanted, I don't know if maybe you guys didn't want one, but I was dying for a BB gun. I wanted a BB gun so freaking bad. And my dad told me there's a good chance there could be one under the Christmas tree. I was waiting every day for that freaking BB gun. I was so excited. That's how I feel while we train. I start getting excited like that BB gun. I start getting jacked up. You know why? Because we get to do something really cool, not like getting a BB gun, like changing our freaking life and earning $50,000 a month checks. And by the way, when I made 700 grand, the guy closest to me was at 100. So I'm gonna explain this to you. He could be like, well, the top guy at my store only earns 20 grand. I'm like, okay, make 100. Who gives a shit? We don't make 100. No one else makes 100. You can. Since when did you like follow everybody else? Guys, one of the things you'll learn about us talking in here is we don't follow anybody, okay? We set our own standard. Am I right? Listen to me. If you can't agree with that, okay, you're going to walk right out that door and they're going to own you. Look, I own my time. I own it. I don't manage time. I own it. Okay? You guys get to decide to do what you want with your own life. Am I right? Quit acting like you don't have control over it because you do. Okay? There's some cool stuff you learn out of these events. Okay, you take one full day, you go home, next 30 days you totally recreate and you gain more ground than you have in the last 10 years in 1 month. Okay, one day more than you had in the last year. It's all you need, just clarity, someone to spell it out for you how to do it. Okay, all right, let's go to the next one right here. But hold on, wait a minute, who won that one?
Evan.
Hold on, we didn't vote. No, we didn't vote, guys. And after they do it now, I'll have you vote before I talk. That way you guys can have it fresh on your heart. But listen, Evan was the first one that came out, or was it Ian?
I went first.
Hold on. So Ian went first.
Yep.
Ian went first.
I was just thinking about playing with BB guns.
Hey.
Shooting
Evan
out.
Went second.
Do you guys, a good picture. I was like, if he hits another objection, I'm getting that.
Do you guys remember who you voted for? Hold on. Do you guys remember? All right. Show of hands for Ian. He went first.
Come on. There we go, baby.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Hold on.
Guys.
You got to keep your hand up. You can't just raise it and then lower it. Mama's going fast. She's going fast. Like a race car. She's counting hands fast.
Oh, I like that, Cooley. That's my boy.
What is it?
That's my boy.
Huh? Ian, all right, guys. We're right here. We're right here. Out.
Hey.
All right, one of you guys go out. Let's go. All right, we're going to move quick, guys. We're going to go really fast. All right.